screamers, preachers, and teachers. This podcast came to me because over this past week I received the same email from maybe like 10 of you cats telling me to look at this conversation between one cat and I guess some Asian dude talking about, you know, why they don't concern themselves with blacks and what Asians do to come together. And, you know, kind of like this black unity thing, like, will we ever come together? I'll answer the first thing first. We're a little bit more highly evolved than most people. You can't just tell black people to come together for the sake of some fuck-ass reason. There has to be a reason. Like a family. A family that comes together during times when there's a need to come together. Otherwise, a strong family takes care and builds their own family and only close ranks when they need to. So don't believe we should all be walking around hand in hand doing all that shit. That shit ain't real. No other race does that. No whites, no Japanese, no Mexicans. Nobody does that. For someone to say that we need to be like that is either we all believe in the same cult or they're out there fucking lying. But I wanted to respond to that because it made me think. Made me think about, you know, how cats are, you know what I'm saying, present this information to other people. And I wanted to start off with the screamers, all right? All of us have been screamed at, probably by our mother, telling us that we should take out the trash, or you should do this or do that. And the problem with the screamers is nobody fucking listens to them because it's like nagging, you know what I mean? So when I see cats put up information, you know, that blacks should be this way, I'm always one. I said, is this motherfucker screaming at me? Is he saying, look at them, we should be like them? You know what I mean? Look at you're fucking up. You should be like them. See, a screamer don't got nothing but a personal complaint. You know what I mean? In other words, like, you're not taking out the trash. You're fucking up your mom's day. So when people tell black people to do something and they're screaming at them, I always say, somehow, the blacks who aren't doing what you need them to do is fucking up your day, fucking up your reputation, fucking up the way you want life to be. You know what I mean? You always hear, I wish black people would act this way. No. I don't mind how you act. I mean, make money, build something for your family. God put us out here to be different. Be different, brother. You don't have to be like me. And I don't agree with everything, but shit, as long as you're productive and positive, I'm with you. But, you know, the screamers are always complaining because somehow, deep down, you're fucking up their day. So, majority of things that come at black people are always the screamers. You know, we shouldn't be this way. We shouldn't have... You know, motherfuckers shouldn't put out sex tape. Motherfuckers shouldn't be this kind of person. And they acting like hoes and they on TV. And you know what I mean? A screamer just talking, homie. You know what I mean? If you're ever about to fight somebody or, you know, a motherfucker start huffing and puffing and screaming and talking and yelling. You, like, goddamn, man. I mean, your fear factor and shit is getting lower and lower. Like, this motherfuckers are going to be screaming at me and shit before a motherfucker come to blows. But... It's a thing of knowing that you're dealing with a certain kind of person. See, a screamer can hide something positive and, you know, he can couch it in a conversation, but really he's screaming at you. Really he's saying, motherfucker, take out the trash. Really he's saying, motherfucker, be like the Chinese dudes. Really, motherfucker, just be like them with the way you are right now, okay. Fucking up. Okay. A screamer will point out all the negatives. It's always negative motivation. Motherfucker, that's why your shoes ain't tied, you know? And, you know, motherfucker, that's why your hair ain't combed. That's why your car ain't shit. They believe by screaming and pointing shit out to you, which is the majority of blacks. That's why I don't want to jump on motherfuckers too harsh, because it's the majority of people. That's how they talk. We talk to each other. We like to scream to each other like motherfuckers are our moms. The only person we can take getting screamed from is usually our moms. I ain't nobody else in this world you're going to let some motherfucker scream at you and you just take it. So since they've been raised by their mom and they don't know how to be a man and they don't know how to address things, they scream. You know what I mean? They, you know, they get on TV and there's some intelligent screamers, brother. There's some people out here who are really smart and all they do is scream too. They just use bigger fucking words or a bigger platform or, you know, write a book and say, hey, you know, the way blacks should be here. You know what I mean? The way we should do this. And you know what I mean? And like, hey, they're screamers. And I want you to know that majority of the time when you see somebody attacking black people, especially each other, when we see each other, most of these motherfuckers are screamers. Somehow you fucking up his day. Somehow you fucking up what he thought he built for himself. You know what I mean? When a black person gets intelligent and his master approves of him, he believes that he has found the winning formula. Master approves of me. Be like me. And when you're not like me, I'm going to scream and shout and band together with other motherfuckers and create a goddamn shout fest. And we're going to start screaming out onto the street. And then we're going to start alienating motherfuckers. And then we're not going to be part of y'all. And then we're going to be grouped together and form motherfuckers who don't want to be around them motherfuckers. There's a lot of screamers in this game, man. They're not positive people. They're not trying to build. They're not trying to do anything. They just trying to say, ow, you fucking up my day. Just like when you step on a cat's tail, homie. Or you kick a dog or something. You yelp. They make a noise. This is the same motherfucker. This, when you hear screamers, it's a sign of a weak motherfucker. Now, the second cat I want to bring into this game is the preachers. Because the preachers, and I'm not talking about a preacher like, you know, like a preacher, like a pastor, a deacon, and all this other weird-ass names of motherfuckers, second apostle to the third Reich and shit. I ain't talking about all these motherfuckers with their funny names. I'm talking about a style in which they intend to influence you. A preacher has read a book, just like your preacher who reads the Bible. And he believes that this book is the way. So he's preaching the Bible, preaching from the book, preaching from his master, preaching from what he has been taught will work. And that's the second motherfuckers who y'all love to respect. Y'all respect motherfuckers who preach from the pulpit. You know what I mean? Y'all, that's who y'all think is, he's enlightened because, you know what, he learned from his bad experiences. And he picked up from bad experiences and bad experiences. It's always something about bad experiences. This motherfucker been married 8 times. He should know what a good marriage look like. And you know what I'm saying? He done been through the well. Now, the problem with a preacher is that all he is a follower. A follower of Jesus Christ. A follower of whatever book he's in. That's all he fucking is. He ain't the dude with the knowledge. He just the motherfucker regurgitating the knowledge that you can go read for yourself. But since most motherfuckers are lazy and you won't go read this shit for yourself, you nominate a motherfucker to say it for you. And if you're really ignorant, you believe the preacher is actually the word he's speaking. And he's not. Now, to smart motherfuckers, smart brothers, smart cats, you ain't following too many preachers. That's why you don't see black men in the church. You can't deal with that shit. We know it's a lie. So the thing is, you only are left with the motherfuckers who are looking, who hope you have an answer. So the preachers only work for the hopeless. They don't work for the motherfuckers who are hopeful. You dig? They don't work on me. When someone says, I'm a pastor, I'm a preacher, I'm a so-and-so, I'm like, I don't give a fuck, homie. What you really got to say? You know what I'm saying? What you going to say? What are you going to interpret? Well, the Bible says, I don't give a fuck what that book says. Homie, what do you say? What have you done? What have you learned? What passage have you walked? What part of his life have you walked through this shit? I want to learn from your experiences. I don't want to learn from Confucius say this. What the fuck, homie? My mama say. How many of my mama says are you going to give me, motherfucker? You know what I'm saying? So it's a thing of knowing that this motherfucker don't know the answer either. He just a well-read motherfucker. Haven't you noticed that when you read books, young homie, that when you read these books, some of these motherfuckers start repeating? Why is there no original thought? Because they aren't the one. But they read the dude who is the one. Most of the time, you need to find out where did that motherfucker get it from? Who is the originator of the thought? You know what I'm saying? If I don't want the follower of Jesus Christ, I want Jesus. Because these motherfuckers been making up shit about Jesus since day one. You know what I'm saying? Now he look like Thor. You know what I'm saying? With blonde locks and shit, throwing them outside of a castle so other motherfuckers can climb up his hair and shit and get to the castle. You know what I'm saying? You dealing with motherfuckers who don't know a goddamn thing. They just know what the example or the teaching of the other dude. But what has he interpreted? You understand what I'm saying? So the majority of people, like I said, you respect on this earth are preachers. Now, they don't call themselves a preacher. They call themselves other names. He's doctor this or so-and-so this or highly respected this. I'm doing this. You should listen to me on this. But they don't know. They just follow. Now, out of the preacher could become a teacher. The problem with that is he has to believe that he has learned more than what his master has given him, which is the same way most of us do, brother. You go from the first grade and you graduate to the second grade. That means you have learned the lessons of the first grade. So a cat who turns around and preaches to second grade, to me, is ignorant. Because this is information to be interpreted, to be assimilated, to be applied, and to build. And once this same man learns how to build what he has assimilated, applied, mentorship, or whatever all them fuck-ass words that y'all like to use, and been under these motherfuckers, he should. Just like you throwing in all that shit into gumbo, homie. Just like you making a special chili or a barbecue sauce. If you throw all the shit in there and you add your own spice to it, it comes out as a different kind of sauce. Now, since these motherfuckers, they just following the thing. They're like a cookbook. And since you don't want to read the cookbook, you think this motherfucker knows how to cook. So a preacher is what majority of us are looking at. Majority of us are following. The majority of us want to be. And that brings me to the teacher. The teacher is most likely the highest form of influence you can have on someone. I attempt to be a teacher. I attempt to put the information out there, let you sit there and absorb it. You understand what I mean? Let you ask the questions, let you apply it in your lane, in your game, wherever you happen to be. You understand what I'm saying? So you can come up with your truth and your application of the base knowledge. You understand what I'm saying? That's what a teacher is, and you don't find many of those kind of people. You don't find many books that tell you exactly how to do something, do you? You know what I'm saying? They always come with some old weird shit. You know what I'm saying? In order to be a good Christian, you need to be the, you know, this is it. You need to pray to the east 5 times a day. You need to do, you know what I'm saying? It's because they're following rules. But where's the interpretation? Where's the thing that I could pick up? Now, a teacher does this automatically. When the last time you had a good teacher, homie? Think about it for a second. What was it that made them so interesting? They taught you in a way that was not only informative, but entertaining. And when you walked out into this earth, it was usable. It was valid. It was viable. You understand what I'm saying? It was not just some abstract shit. When most of us think about chemistry or think about fucking astronomy and all this shit, you think, who gives a fuck? Now, if he would have taught that to the slaves, astronomy, maybe they would have all saw the North Star and figured they'd been able to use the sky as a compass. Now, that's viable. He would have been a great teacher to the slaves for their escape plan. But for you, he's nothing. So a teacher not only gives you the information, he wants to give it to you, or she wants to give it to you in a way that allows you to apply it and use it where you are. As you know, I'm from California, homie. It's the West. And I don't have too much snow. So when we talk about hustle and I include snow, I got to throw out the base level of snow. Now, I lived in the snow and dealt with the snow, but I haven't grown up in the snow. So when I apply a game or give you a hustle or something on snow, on how to use snow, on how to make money doing lawns for other motherfuckers, I got to keep it very base, abstract to let the motherfucker, the cat from Buffalo, do his thing. Because he sees it every day, every winter. You understand what I'm saying? Now, I have taught that cat probably not how to do the snow or how to manipulate or make money, but I gave him the lane and how to use it. That was the teacher in me. Do you see this shit? Do you see that shit over there with that snow? Like, damn, homie, do you see that shit? It's hotter than a motherfucker in Chicago. Do you see this shit? Do you see how you can apply and build here? That's my job as a teacher. To provoke the thought, the insight from you to build, to do something with. And like I said, go back to your books, homie. Y'all all been reading books. I'm a simple cat, homie. How, and I'm going to be brutally honest with you. I'm amazed that no one has written a book giving blueprints to how to get out of poverty. And if and I don't know, I don't think I'm the, I hope I'm not the first one to actually say, do it this way. But I'm amazed to say, why no one came along and said, you don't have to be like them. You don't have to run the game like them. Here, do this first. We can get you out of this shit, homie. You 21 getting out of college. Apply this shit by 25. You gonna be scot-free. You won't have to go to work like the rest of them suckers. Obama done gave you health care, homie. We don't even need to go get a job for these motherfuckers no more, homie. You dig? So it's just interesting that nothing came along. But I'm a firm believer that the teacher it's harder to find because I think it's for me, and I'm not trying to boost myself up. It was just a thought process that I put forth. And it was a thought process that was a little bit different from everyone else. So I assume there might be teachers in all of us, homie, but not all of us going to stand up and say, them motherfuckers don't know what they talking about, man. Here, do it this way, this way, this way. Apply game this way. And then you're going to run into the preachers who say the tried and true way is the way that Jehovah said it back in 17 AD or whatever the motherfuckers who they believe in. You know what I'm saying? And the screamer is going to say, don't do that. Don't run your own business like Freeman. 9 out of 10 people fail. 10 out of 10 people are assholes. 11 out of 10 people are homo thugs. Chauncey. They going to come with everything. So I can understand why the dude with the original thought gets pushed down. I can understand why you can't find the book. I can understand why it's hard to build, brother. You just how many cats are walking around trying to find a solution. So let me run this back into the beginning. Let me run that circle on you, homie, get back to where we started from. I saw this sheet of paper. I saw this thing. You know, like I said, a couple of cats sent it to me on Facebook and email. I got a lot of this motherfucker, so it must have been profound for a lot of cats. I sat down, analyzed it, thought about what the Asian dude was saying. And the first thing I thought to myself was, I don't give a fuck. I mean, I just straight up, man. Everybody got a comment about the black man. Because they're all screamers. And they all say, why don't you be like this? Right? And then the dude who delivers that paper is the preacher. Saying, look at this. Look at this example. You should be this example. And then no one comes along who's the teacher. No one gave you a blueprint on how we're going to go about doing this shit. No one said, hey, this is the solution. Do this first. If all black people learn how to balance their finances, which is what most dumb motherfuckers think is the way to make money, you first got to learn how to manage your money. Man, hustle, young man, hustle. First thing you need to know how to do is make motherfucking money, and a lot of it. We'll learn how to manage it as we lose it, as we fuck it up. That's the game you want to be in, not the one. We'll take your $2,000 and break it down. And let's see what your expenses are. There's $500 for this. There's $200 for groceries. You're left with a $200 disposable income. That's why nobody ever get rich. So on that paper, we see a cat asking the Chinaman, or I'm sorry, Japanese dude. I don't know who he is. You know what I mean? What he thought and why his race does this. And I got mad at it. This is the second part. Intellectually, I understand that he's a screamer. Emotionally, I started thinking to myself, why? How? What do you think is going to happen because of this? Black people going to say, oh shit, he finally gave us the answer. I mean, why would you put that shit out there? You know what I mean? Ooh, we finally got, ooh, that was finally the scream that made me do it, take out the trash, mom. That was it. When you screamed at me the 17th time, I got up and took out the trash. See, I'm often disappointed in people. You understand what I'm saying? Because I always think, you know, we got a lot of smart brothers in this game. And I mean no disrespect to anybody. You know what I'm saying? We all got a lane. And we all trying to get someplace. And my challenge to everyone is always the same challenge you put to me. Well, Freeman, what you going to do about it? Well, what you going to do, man? You talking like every other motherfucker in this game, homie. What you going to do? So I challenge most of us the same way. All right, homie, now that we know, what's the answer, though? I don't know the answer, man. I just wanted to put it out there so everybody else can learn from. What are we learning? That Chinese people or Japanese people think we shit? We knew that. Haven't you learned, young brother, that almost everybody in this world thinks we're the worst thing to come? It's okay. They're wrong. But they're scared because we aren't following their direction. When a black man doesn't want to be anything else but himself, he will not look like them. And that scares the rest of them. You know what I mean? For the Chinese man or the Japanese man to say that he's accumulating money so one day rival the white people who are in control of it is his ignorance manifest. He's going to go on the master's plantation to take money from the master. The master owns everything, and what you produce, he still gets a cut up. Retarded. If you understand the logic, it's just retarded. You will never be able to be on someone else's land and then carve out your own fucking niche. That's just retardation. You gotta get your own shit, homie. And that's what I preach and teach and sometimes scream. But I wanted you to know, man, it's three cats in this game, man. The screamers, the preachers, and the teachers. Now, you guys been listening to Rise and Grind for years, man. I'm trying to make you all teachers. I'm trying to give you the examples, the things to go out there and explain it to another cat so he can ponder on that shit. Don't get it twisted. There's been plenty of times in my life and travels where I just met people and they kind of just said one thing to me and they're like, damn, I never thought of the game that way. And I thank them for being a teacher, not a preacher, not a screamer, but a teacher. This is how these motherfuckers making money. You ever thought about it that way? Look how the game is laid out, homie, bop, 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 bop. I thank them for being a teacher. Now, I send this out in the same hopes as the dude who's the screamer sent his shit out. Let's work on providing solutions, not just telling people that black people are poor. Motherfucker, we know that. Not saying that black people believe in a white God. I say that all the time. Motherfucker, you should know that too. You believe in a white God. But you know what I'm saying? Without giving you steps, let me answer the white God one, because I never want to miss a moment of not saying this shit. Every other race has an interpretation of God. The Indians, the Hindus, the Pakistanis, or whatever. None of them take the white man's God and said that's their God, except us. I'll leave you with that. Except us. Somehow think that's okay to take the white man's God and make it our God. But I want us to all be teachers. And I want that brother, whoever put that shit out, I don't even know where that shit came from. I hope he become a teacher. Stop telling us what's wrong. Start telling us what's right. Or if you can't tell us what's right, tell us the steps to get what's right. Next time, partner.